everyone. I wanted to do a little fall haul today. I've done a lot of shopping in the past few months, and I just really wanted to share what I've been buying because I've never really had a lot of fall clothes. I've always had a ton of things to wear in the summer, but I've just never really been that into fall and winter. So I think I've never really bought clothes for the season. But this season I went a little crazy and I did a lot of shopping, so I thought I'd share what I got with you guys. So first I got this Aquies candle at Soho Boutique in Hyde Park. And if you're not familiar with Aquies, their candles are really, really nice. I love this brand. It actually comes in a glass jar, if you can see it. It's just really substantial, and I love the lid too, even the lid is made of glass. And this scent is in Black Orchid, and it just smells almost like cologne. I just love this scent. It almost smells really musky and manly, and I just think that's a great scent for this time of year. Next, I got this white t-shirt. It's just a plain white tee, and it has a little bit of stretch to it. And this brand is called The Fifth, and I got it at Curate Boutique, which is also in Hyde Park. And I live in Cincinnati, if I've never mentioned that before. So all these local boutiques are in Cincinnati. And this is just a really comfy, stretchy white t-shirt. Next, I got this plaid black and white blouse from Banana Republic, and I was actually at Banana a few weeks ago, and I've been wearing this shirt probably 2 or 3 times a week. It just goes with everything. Like, I am obsessed with black and white clothes. I try to buy colorful things, but I just think cute things come in black and white. I don't know why, maybe that's just me, but I always seem to gravitate toward black and white this time of year. Next, I went to Ann Taylor, and I actually bought this hat, and I am in love with it. I cannot tell you how obsessed I am with this hat. I wear it every single day. I'd wear it to bed if that was normal. It's so comfortable. I'm obsessed with the sparkly detail on it. It's literally gorgeous. It's so weird. I actually have been wanting a hat just like this for months. I didn't know it actually existed. I just was thinking in my head it would look really cute. And I walked into Ann Taylor, and right in front of my eyes was this hat. Oh, I knew I had to have this hat. And it actually came in, like, I want to say 3 other colors. I tried it on in a gray, and I think they had a black as well. But it's just so comfortable. It literally goes with any coat that you have, and the sparkle detail is just incredible. So that has been probably my favorite, like, wintry accessory I've bought lately. So the next thing I bought was also from Ann Taylor. They had so many cute things in Ann Taylor. Like, their fall and winter stuff is just crazy right now. I could have gone crazy in that store. I wanted everything. Everything had a little bit of sparkle to it, and they had a lot of things with bow ties, which, if you follow my blog, I'm obsessed with things with bow ties. I love it. So obviously, I had to get this top from Ann Taylor. It's hard to see right now, but this actually is an elastic bow tie, and you can literally put it on any shirt, which is incredible. I obviously wear it with the shirt it came with, but this shirt is so comfortable and flattering. I love it, and I just love that this detaches too, because I have other blouses that I actually can wear this with, which is perfect. This actual shirt, I loved the detailing on the sleeves. I'm a sucker for, like, a fun sleeve. And I probably will buy a shirt if it has a cool sleeve. I really can't say no. And this sleeve, I thought, was adorable. It kind of has a little ruffle detail and it's very feminine. So the next store I went to recently was actually the Gap Clearance Center, which is in Hebron, Kentucky. So you really have to dig at stores like that. But I did find a few things that were in great shape, and I actually bought, I think, two things from there. The first thing I got was this skirt. It's kind of a maroon burgundy color, and it has the black piping all down the front and back of it. It's more of like a fitted skirt. The brand of this is Tinley Road, which is a Piperlime brand, and I just love it. Like, it is very fitted, which I don't wear a lot of fitted clothes, but I think with tights it's really cute. And I have worn this out with long black sweaters and just some heels. The next thing I got from the Piperlime outlet is actually this anorak. And I have never owned an anorak in my life. I don't know if I'm saying that word right, but I've always wanted one. I've seen really cute ones at J.Crew and other stores, but they were just so expensive and I could never bring myself to actually buy one. But I found this one by Hive and Honey at the Piperlime store, and it was like $30, so I knew I should probably buy this one. It has really cute detailing, and it also has that cinched waist, which I really like. So I've worn that a few times already. So the next store I've done some damage at lately is Trend Boutique. And that's actually in Oakley in Cincinnati. And I love Trend. They have really affordable things that are on trend, like the name of the store says. And I just love it. I really didn't have a lot of outerwear coming into this season. I actually, in college, which was, let's see, my sophomore year of college was like 4 years ago. And I actually left all of my outerwear in college when I moved out, which was literally devastating. I still haven't been able to move past it. I left a ski jacket, really cute winter coats, just everything. I had vests in there, and just literally every single piece of outerwear that I owned, I left in a coat closet and realized a week after college ended that I had forgotten them. So the first thing I got was this peplum vest. I don't know if you can see the peplum detail, but yeah, I've never seen a peplum vest until I went into Trend, and I thought it was genius. And the brand of this vest is Tulle, and Tulle has been one of my favorite brands since I was like in eighth grade. I've bought a ton of Tulle stuff over the years, and I actually still have it, which is crazy. My stuff from Tulle has always been in really good shape, and it's really worn well over the years, which that makes me love a brand even more if their clothes can last throughout the years without getting faded or worn. So the next thing I bought at Trend was another coat. So the next thing I bought at Trend was another piece of outerwear, and I have worn this every single day since I bought it. I probably should not be wearing it as much because I don't want it to get worn, but I just love it so much. It's this blue coat, and it's a long coat, and it has this really fuzzy material. I don't know if you can tell on the screen, but it's really fuzzy, and it's just so adorable, and it has a front zip detail to it. So it doesn't really have a big collar, but I just love it. It's really minimalistic, and it just looks cute with everything that I have. I've been wearing it almost every single day, and I've gotten so many compliments on this jacket. I just think people love the material of it because it is really soft, and I've had a lot of people actually ask if they can pet me, which is kind of weird, but I think everyone just loves this fuzzy material. And the color of this is gorgeous. I love powder blue, and I think it can look really pretty in the winter too, especially against the snow. And I've actually been wearing this with almost a purple fuchsia lip color, and it looks amazing. So the last thing I bought from Trend recently was actually this silky plaid blouse. And it's more of like a boyfriend relaxed fit. The sleeves are really loose, if you can see. And it does have a little bit of a sheer detail to it. But this shirt's really comfortable too. I always like buying things in the fall and winter that are cute but really comfortable because I hate being cold. And I'm always, always cold. So I want things to be comfortable too, because the worst thing to me is being cold and uncomfortable. So I also have a few beauty favorites for this fall. One of them is this nail polish from OPI. It's in the color Black Onyx. And it really is just like a jet black. I have it on my nails right now, if you can see. Next, I got this Revlon Color Burst. It's a balm stain, and it's in the shade Enticing Desirable. And I've used these lip pencils before, but I've never used one of these. This is actually like a shiny one. I don't know the difference between that. I have some of the matte looking ones. But this seriously goes on like butter. I actually have it on my lips right now, and I've been wearing this a ton because my lips get really chapped this time of year, and I've noticed that this kind of helps keep them hydrated while giving them color. So one of my last favorites that I've gotten recently is this Tara Lee Smith choker necklace. And it actually sparkles. I'm not sure if you can see it or not, but it is gorgeous. I actually bought this from Tara. I've done a lot of work with her for my blog, and her jewelry is incredible. I don't even know how to describe it. She literally is an artist. I'm not really into traditional art, but I love jewelry, and Tara's jewelry is art. Like, that's my favorite art form, I've realized, is her jewelry. She just can take a boring old piece and recreate it into something that's incredible. And this necklace is just insane. So this is a close-up shot of the necklace, and it's just so ornate and detailed. I love it. It's like a copper color, and then it has these little rhinestones right here, and just all the detailing. Like, Tara knows how to add so much detail to a necklace, and just everything comes together and just looks perfect together. I can't explain it. Her jewelry is literally amazing. I'll post a link to her website down below, but you should definitely check out her stuff. So that's everything for my fall haul. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and I've really started to love making videos. I think this is my fourth video that I've done, and I'm really loving it so far. So I'm looking forward to making a lot more videos, and if you have any suggestions for videos that I should do, please feel free to leave me a comment or send me a message, and I will see you guys soon.